Hello kids, how are you doing? I hope you all are doing well. Today, I'm going to start a new lesson from your Marigold book. That is from Unit 4. And the name of the lesson is My Elder Brother. Do you have elders in your house who constantly tell you what you should be doing all day? Do they monitor how do you spend your time? Have they ever made a timetable for you to make sure that you don't waste any of your time? Let us see how these questions are related to the chapter. My Elder Brother. This short play is about two brothers who are affectionate and respectful to each other. The story also shows that learning from our day-to-day experiences is as important as what we learn from books in the school. This play is based on the famous story in Hindi, Bade Bhai Sahab, written by Munshi Premchand. This story is a short play, and it is about two brothers who are loving and they respect each other. The story shows how important are our day-to-day experiences. They are as important as the knowledge that we gain from our books in the school. This lesson is based on a very famous story written by Munshi Premchand in Hindi. Munshi Premchand was a very, very famous writer. His contribution to the Indian literature is valuable. And he has also taken Indian literature to an international level. Let us see what significant teachings does this chapter has for us. But before that, let us look at the word meanings of this short introduction. Affectionate means showing love and fondness. Respectful means showing admiration or respect. Experiences. An event or occurrence which leaves an impression on someone. As I have told you in the beginning that this particular lesson is a play, so let us talk about different genres of English literature. Poetry, drama, or prose. These are the different genres of writing English literature. So let us discuss each of them one by one. Poems are written in lines and stanzas instead of sentences and paragraphs. It has many forms. However, the lyrical undertone is common in all these forms. Poetry may not necessarily follow a rhyming scheme. So children, can you name a few poems that we have learned from your NCERT book? Yes, the first one that we did was Ice Cream Man, Teamwork, and My Shadow. These are a few poems that we have learned. You will see there is a difference between how these poems and other chapters are written. The next genre that we have been studying but we do not know what it is prose. Prose is made up of sentences and paragraphs without any metrical or rhyming structure. Prose in simpler terms is a short story. So, the different lessons that we have learned, like Wonderful Waste, Robinson Crusoe Discovers a Footprint, Flying Together, these lessons are examples of prose. These are short stories written in sentences and paragraphs, and they do not have a metrical structure, any rhyming scheme or a metered structure. The next genre that we are going to study about is drama. Drama is a piece of writing that tells a story. It is performed on a stage and uses dialogues. Drama is composed of many acts. An act further has many scenes. A scene basically is the script with each character speaking their lines. So this lesson that we are going to learn right now, My Elder Brother, is a play. which involves characters, and you will see each character speaking their lines. Basically, plays or dramas can be enacted on stage. So, let us begin this interesting play, My Elder Brother, which talks about two brothers. There are two main characters in this play, Bhaiya and Munna. Let us read through and understand what kind of relationship do these two brothers share. Scene 1. A hostel room. Two brothers aged 9 and 14 years sitting at a study table. The elder brother, Bhaiya, is reading a book and the younger one, Munna, is drawing pictures of birds and animals. A scene is very significant as far as a play is concerned. So, what is a scene? In a drama, a scene is a unit of action, often a subdivision of an action. It basically tells you about a sequence where a character or characters engage in some sort of action or dialogue. Let us go back to our lesson. So, scene 1 tells you about a hostel room where two brothers aged 9 and 14 are sitting on a study table and they are doing their work and discussing something.
What are you doing, Munna?
I am drawing.
When will you study? Where were you in the morning?
Turning pale.
I was playing. Bhaiya, how can you sit with the book for hours together?
That's because I want my foundation in education to be very strong. If the base is strong, then the building will stand firmly. Sometimes it takes me 2 years to do 1 year's work.
Bhaiya, you are 5 years older than I am and 3 classes ahead of me. I wonder why you keep writing the same word 20 times, one sentence more than 20 times, and copy poems several times in beautiful letters.
You know, studying English is no child's play. One has to work very hard in order to learn the subject, to speak or write English properly. Tremendous effort is required. But the moment you get a chance, you run to the field, play marbles and fly paper kites, or sit idling away with friends for fun. Can't you sit down and study?
So, this is a conversation between Bhaiya and Munna. Bhaiya, being the elder one, monitors how his younger brother is spending his time. So, Bhaiya, being the elder one, asked Munna what was he doing. And Munna in turn replied that he was drawing. And Bhaiya asked him that when would he study and where was he in the morning. Here, if you notice, turning pale is written in brackets. It means that it tells you about an expression or something that happens in the background in a play. So, Munna turning pale, that means Munna's expression was as if he's scared to answer that particular question. And this part in the bracket is always read by a narrator of the story, who narrates you the whole scene. So, hesitatingly, Munna replied that he was playing. And then he asks Bhaiya that how did he manage to sit for hours together with his books? Bhaiya told Munna that he wanted his basics to be strong and therefore he studied for so long, and sometimes he also took 2 years to complete 1 year's work. He wanted to be thorough with the concepts and so he practiced a lot. Here, Bhaiya tells Munna about the importance of strong foundation, strong basics. That if the basics were strong, the building would stand firmly. All the concepts that you learn in further classes would be clear only if the foundation or basics were strong. So, Munna asks Bhaiya that he was only 5 years older to him and he was 3 classes ahead. And Munna always wondered why would he keep writing the same words 20 times. One sentence more than 20 times. And also he several times saw Bhaiya writing poems in beautiful letters. Munna had so many questions to ask Bhaiya. Bhaiya patiently replied to all his questions, gave him answers and explained him all the things. And to these questions, Bhaiya replied that learning English was not an easy task. It was not a child's play. It was one hard task which required a lot of hard work. It required tremendous effort, a lot of effort. After telling him all this, Bhaiya quickly said that Munna never utilized his time well. He always ran to the field, played with marbles, flew paper kites and sat and wasted time with his friends for fun. So, Bhaiya wanted Munna to sit and study. Before winding up for now, let us quickly recapitulate the word meanings. Turning pale means change in a person's skin color when the person is ill or frightened. Here in the story, because Munna was scared of Bhaiya's questions, he turned pale. Foundation, basis of something or starting point. Firmly, strongly or in a way that will not become loose. No child's play means something which is not easy. Tremendous means very great in amount, scale or intensity. Effort, a determined attempt. And idling means spending time doing nothing. That's all for now, children. We will continue the lesson in the next class and find out more about Bhaiya and Munna. Thank you so much for watching, children. Take good care of yourself. Bye-bye.